Sophia. Thank you for being here. How are you today?
Hi, I'm very well, thank you, and thank you for having me.
Yeah, it's not a problem. So, you're from Bulgaria, you're a soccer player. Why did you choose soccer as your sport, and how did it all start?
Well, it's actually a very interesting story. I'm from a very small town in Bulgaria, and there's not very many sports to participate. And I've always been a boy girl. I always liked to play with the boys, whatever sports, but somehow I think soccer chose me because I had a group of boys that we were always playing on the soccer field. But one day my group didn't show up, and my dad, who's a soccer coach, had a practice with his team.
Yeah.
And the boys in his team were from my class in high school.
Yeah.
And they offered me to, since I'm there, to just practice with them, and I decided, yeah, why not? And basically that's how everything started for me, from there to the teams that I've been later on.
Okay, that's good. So when did you make your first appearance for the Bulgarian national team? Because I know that's really interesting and it must be a big achievement for you.
Yeah, well, as I said, when I started playing for my dad's team in the championship they're having the boys,
yeah,
one of the soccer coaches saw me and he offered me to go and play for a women's team in a city that was 2 hours away from my hometown.
Okay.
And basically with my very first game for them, the coaches from the national team under 17 saw me and they sent me a call up for the national team. And I think my first game was against Turkey, and we played in Bulgaria. And since then, I haven't missed a national team under 17, under 19, and then later on, I played for the women's national team.
Well, that's good, though. So on the age of 18, you made your debut in the WSL1, which is the Women's Super League in England, which is a really high standard, as I'm aware. How did this happen?
Well, again, everything in my life is just going a very weird ways. You never know when you're gonna get the opportunity. But I was very young. I wasn't ready for this opportunity because I was still in high school, 12th grade, getting ready for the exams. And all of a sudden, I got this opportunity. My coach, that was in my first team, women's team in Bulgaria, he went to live in England, and then he contacted Bristol City,
yeah,
the team that I was playing for in the WSL, and I had to go there and prove myself, because for Bulgarian people, we don't just get a contract to sign, you just,
yeah,
have to go try yourself, and if they like you on the tryouts, they offer you a contract, and that's what exactly happened with me, which I'm very happy for, and it was a great time.
So tell me a bit of the achievements you got in England. Like, did you win anything with your team, or?
I want to say mostly it was for me developing. I couldn't, especially in Bristol, I wanted to achieve more. You know, I was very young, and I became a star in my country, and I thought that's my time. From now on, I'll just conquer England and we'll achieve even more. But I couldn't get the time that I needed to play because, as I said, I was very young, and the girls in the team, actually women, because they were like 25, 30
yeah,
years old, and I didn't have the right experience. And my coach was always saying, Evie, it's okay at the time, you need more years to get into these girls' places. You can't just come, you know, you have to prove yourself. I don't think I didn't show on practice that I deserved to play,
yeah,
but it was just the fact that they were more experienced, that they've been in the team for many years, and I couldn't prove myself there, I guess. But then I was fortunate enough to go to London Bees, which,
yeah,
is in second division in England. I know maybe it was a step back, but only to accelerate after that.
Exactly, yeah.
Because I got enough time to play there. And my biggest achievement will probably be my game against Chelsea, which was current champion of England,
yeah.
and we played them for the Continental Cup. And so that day, I'm very excited when I speak about that game, because we beat them with penalties. So we played extra time and penalties. It was 120 minutes of game playing the whole time. And
yeah.
when I was in Bristol, I couldn't even get the chance to play 10 minutes against Chelsea, and we were losing.
That must have been such a difference, though.
Yes, and you know, when you really just want to play, my team was in Bristol, always
yeah.
losing from Chelsea, and I wasn't playing, and now from a team who people will say, you have no chance to beat Chelsea. We beat them, and they were no longer part of the Continental Cup, and we were the first team from second division to make it to the semi-finals of the Continental Cup, which is a great achievement, historical achievement for this team.
It really is. So, you're currently playing soccer at University of Northwestern Ohio, but why did you give up your professional soccer career in England to play here in America?
Very interesting question. I always like to say that America was my biggest dream, and that was the reason for me to decide so impulsive, because it was actually my first offer to come here. I never know if I tried to look deep into it, I could have got a better offer. And I didn't actually look for the school. It was the current coach Stuart Gore, who contacted me on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
And I saw the opportunity, and knowing that that's America,
yeah.
didn't want to regret one day. Don't want to live my life with regrets and ask myself 1,000 times, why didn't you go in America when you had the chance? What could have happened? So there is always risk, and I decided I'm giving up for now, with the goal that maybe after my college career, one day I can be professional in America, which is my biggest dream, and maybe the reason why I first came here, to hopefully make it to the professional level one day.
Okay, that's fair. So out of all your experiences in football, do you think you regret any decision you've made?
No, because as I said, I don't want to live my life with regrets. Every decision I've made, it's been made on based on big desire. And if I had this desire to come to America, or to go in England, play professional, or to switch from playing in first league to second league,
yeah.
some people might say that's a bad decision. Some people might think it's a bad decision to just throw your professional career to go and be in college and study,
yeah.
but I do not regret, because I know how excited I was, and even if you ask my mother, she knows how happy that I, the face was, like the smile was always in my face before I went to Bristol and before I came here,
yeah.
just because of that excitement, and I cannot regret something that I desired so much.
Mm-hmm. So you've won Female Player of the Year in your country, Bulgaria. Do you think that's your biggest achievement?
Well, definitely it is one of my biggest achievements, but I cannot put one over the other. Yes, it means a lot to me, but as well as my winning All-American Player, Offensive Player of the Year as well. This year has been one of the best, I mean the past year, right? 2017 has been one of the best for me, but I won 2016 as well Player of the Year in Bulgaria, and it means a lot, because it's from the whole country, it's me the one to be the best. But this awards, whether it's a team award or individual award,
yeah.
they all mean a lot to me and give me an extra motivation to keep on practicing. And,
just to keep pushing, really, isn't it?
Yes.
To make you a better player.
And they are all earned with a lot of hard work and dedication. They're not just given to me. And I think.
So tell me, what is your future goal? Do you wish to play soccer or do you wish to coach, or, you know, you tell me.
Well, I'm very ambitious, and I have quite a lot of goals, but it's one step at a time. So at the moment, I'm hoping I can go and play in Division One.
Yeah.
We've already been national champions, which is a great achievement here at UNOH, and I'm looking for the next step. I'm hoping if I can be in Division One and get drafted, if not, to know more people, contact people that will help me in the future, and go through the back doors, you want to say, and just at least go on tryouts, because for a person like me from a country like mine, you actually have to prove yourself. They're not just going to offer you a contract.
Yeah.
It would be really nice if they can just offer me a contract. If not, I'm ready to go and prove myself that I deserve to be in a team and play professional. I'm really hoping, but as I said, one step at a time, a lot of hard work, and for the future, that's my goal. But the biggest thing for me is to be successful, whether soccer, maybe, you never know, I can have injuries, and
yeah,
one day I might not be able to play. That's why I'm also here in college to study.
Yeah.
But really hoping I can make it with soccer. If not, it's important to be successful, and success doesn't come to you, you go to it. You just have to keep on pushing and moving forward regardless of
exactly
what's happening.
Exactly.
So, and one thing that I always like to say is there are things that does not up to me, but what it does is I can give my best. There are circumstances that might stop me. Injuries, you can't make plans because, you know, man makes plans, God lives.
Yeah.
But all you can do is to give your best, and whatever happens, at least one day, I know I tried, I gave my best, gave my all, and that's what happened. Unfortunately, I didn't make it, but I could be on the other side and say, okay, I'm here, I'm on top of the world. Made it.
Exactly.
I'm hoping this will happen.
So I wish you all the best for the future, and I thank you again for your time.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.